In this video, we'll check the library prep kit and sequencing platform documentation before talking about what to do if guidance is not found in either of those documents. Here I'm looking at the Illumina DNA Prep reference guide, and I'll navigate to the dilute libraries to the starting concentration section. We can see a table with recommended final library loading concentrations for different Illumina platforms. These are starting concentration recommendations and may require subsequent optimization in your lab. Here, I'm looking at the NextSeq 1000 and 2000 sequencing system guide. I'll navigate to the dilute library section. We see a table with recommended final concentrations for different Illumina library types. Again, keep in mind that these are starting concentration recommendations and may require subsequent optimization in your lab. If guidance is not found in either the library prep kit or sequencing platform documentation, we can choose a starting concentration based on the library size in relation to Illumina's SPI-X control. Here I'm looking at a technical bulletin that outlines platform-specific loading concentrations for a SPI-X run, also known as a validation run. The table shows the sequencing platform on the left, optimal SPI-X loading concentration in the middle, and the resulting optimal cluster density range on the right. Illumina's SPI-X control library has an average size of 500 base pairs. If your library average size is smaller than SPI-X, choose a concentration lower than what's listed in the table. If your average library size is larger than SPI-X, choose a concentration at or higher than what's listed in the table. Note that if we're sequencing a low base diversity library, Illumina recommends targeting a 30 to 40% reduction from the optimal cluster density range, so choose a lower concentration. This method may require subsequent optimization, as every library type can have different clustering efficiency.